For your next book to select, Dr. Carla Hayden from the Enoch Pratt Free Library is here with a few recommendations. And this month, we're going to focus on Black history. Good morning.
Good morning. And you mentioned mysteries
yes.
and how things turn out. And with Black history, there are so many stories to be told. And one of the best sellers that's out now, and it has received all types of awards, The Warmth of Other Suns, it by Isabel Wilkinson. She tells the story of three people. She interviewed 1,000 mm-hmm. people to get their stories about the Black migration from the South to all parts of the United States. Mm-hmm. And you never know when you're reading these stories of the three that she picked and followed how it's going to turn out. And it just gives you American history, but also Black history, and then it keeps you in suspense.
Yeah, because it's a story of these three people.
These three yeah. people. One of the people was actually a physician who treated and was the personal physician for Ray Charles.
Oh, my goodness.
So you get to go to Hollywood,
yeah.
and you get to see what was happening then. So that one, and it's still, this is a number one bestseller.
Bestseller.
Malcolm X. Mm-hmm. You think you know the story of Malcolm X. This book has been getting all types of awards. It's Malcolm X, A Life of Reinvention. And there are little known facts in here. It took the author almost 20 years, and he died 4 days before it was published.
Oh my gosh.
Manning Marble. So this one is hot. It's now in paperback, and people are just grabbing it off the shelf. This one, my mother, I'm telling you, Harry Belafonte, my story.
Mm-hmm.
You think you know he was an actor, he's mm-hmm. an actor, but you didn't know that he's an activist, and many people didn't realize that. He was a very close personal friend of Dr. Martin mm-hmm. Luther King. And so in the story, he goes from Jamaica
yeah.
as a poor boy in mm-hmm. Jamaica all the way up to leading a lot of the civil rights stories and things.
Such an interesting
man, too.
He's
a very interesting man. And as I say, in a certain generation, they remembered him for that.
Oh, yes, definitely.
And then a local hero. Eddie Brown, who's a local philanthropist mm-hmm. and has done so much for the city of Baltimore, his book, Beating the Odds, his own life story, is flying off the shelves.
No kidding.
Because it talks about how he, you know, he's a financial guru
right.
now. Well, his uncle was the one that really got him started on that. And his uncle was sort of a numbers runner type of guy.
A
little shady, but he taught him about taught him about finance in a nice way, in a good way. And then there's a lot of talk about what does it mean to be Black?
Mm-hmm.
And Torre, who writes for Rolling Stone, has a book that everybody's talking about. It's about what is it to be Black now? And then the Tuskegee Airmen.
Yeah, and it's so popular, I mean, too, with the movie
so
that's out
popular,
right now.
And it really inspires young people.
Absolutely. And then, what color is my world?
You might, this is for young people, but also young at heart. And it is the Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, mm-hmm. who is really well known in terms of his basketball
oh, sure.
career. He also is an activist in civil rights, and he put a book together about the history of African-American inventors. And it is a wonderful book because it, one, it's just beautiful.
And colorful.
Colorful. It has all types of activities.
Yeah.
And it introduces young people, and young at heart, to the fact that an African-American invented the stoplight.
Right.
The electric stoplight, refrigeration, so you can get your fruits and vegetables in the winter.
That is so awesome.
All kinds of things that you wouldn't think about.
What age group would that start with?
This would actually be about 8 to 10 years old.
Perfect.
I think you could start, but
yeah,
you could also and really
okay.
take it all the way up. So
Real
this
quickly,
is a wonderful.
There's one more book you wanted to talk about.
Yes.
That we didn't bring, but
we didn't bring it. Because it is hard to get, and so please get it at the bookstore.
Okay.
Melissa Harris Perry has written a book about the portrayals of African-American women,
mm-hmm.
and that's really hot in terms of the First Lady
Absolutely.
And what she said about that. So
the
it's called Sister,
and, sure.
Sister Shame and Sister Citizen.
Okay, that
so
sounds
that
like a good
one,
one.
That one's off. It's hard to get. I couldn't even get a copy.
Shoo, I love when you come in. You have great choices always. Thank you, Dr. Hayden, so
thank
much.
You.
And please don't go.